most stalwart activist in this country and who absolutely is someone we need to give a rousing reception to. Please welcome Cindy Sheehan.
Hey, Dave Robinson from Brooklyn, I see you. Is anybody out there? Yeah. Let's make some noise! Woo. Let's tell that war criminal in the whorehouse, I mean the White House, how we feel! And I want to apologize to all the sex workers out there! Anyway, so here we are again. The 12th anniversary of shocking and awful. But that's not the first bombing of Iraq. The United States has been bombing Iraq through four administrations since 1991. Now they want to bomb Iraq more. Obama has asked for authorization to use more military force against Iraq. And the only thing that causes is more violence and more destabilization. You can't bomb people into submission. The country is in tatters, and let's talk about another country in tatters. In 2010, we were out here. We were protesting the invasion of Iraq, and the maniacs, the war criminals in the U.S. government started bombing Libya. Now that country is in tatters. You know, I hate to say this. No, I don't. I was lying when I said I hate to say this. But I've been speaking for 45 seconds at least. I haven't said one F word yet. Yay, Cindy! But anyway, if McCain or Romney, if they were bombing six or seven or eight countries like Obama is, if they were threatening Russia like Obama is, if they said that Venezuela was a national threat to the United States, raise your hand if you stay up at night worried that there's a Venezuelan in your closet. Who's worried about Venezuela invading us? Like the sister said earlier, we don't have anything to worry about. The regime, capitalism, imperialism, they have to worry about the threat of a good example from Venezuela. So if this was a Republican in there, there would be tens of thousands of people out here, and there were tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands of people out here protesting Bush's two wars. You know, let's divorce our anti-war activism from the Democratic Party. We cannot simultaneously be pro-Democrat and pro-peace. To be a relevant movement, we cannot support people who promise more war ever. To be relevant, we have to say humanity is more important than which political party has that house or the house down the street, right? So please, in 2016, if it's Hillary versus Jeb, you can't say we loathe Hillary. You can say that. But don't say, but if we don't vote for Hillary, then Jeb will get elected. Do you need any more proof that Barack Obama is a sociopathic war criminal? Do you need any more proof of that? Is there anything else that he needs to do to prove that? And we're here to say, the people all over the world, not just the people in this country, but the people all over the world have an existential right to be free of U.S. imperial domination. And we stand in solidarity with the people of the world and the people here in our inner cities who are battling the same forces, just in a different location.
That's right.